What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? We are back again with another Sister Wives video, and this one right here is episode 3 of season 17. So without no further ado, let's start off by giving a big massive shout out to every single person that is a member of the channel, that is a member of Patreon, and that is a subscriber as we continue to grow. And with that being said, let's not waste any more time and see exactly what goes down this week.
Today is mine and Cody's anniversary. It's so loaded. Anniversary? I don't even know. I don't consider myself married to him anymore at all. 6 weeks ago, we had a conversation. I just said, I need you to let me go. It's over. I don't want to be married to you anymore. And I'm also going to be moving to Utah. So I don't know when to have a conversation with my sister wives. I don't know when to tell Truly. I don't know. But no one really knows the finale of all of this, I think. But anyway, I told him before I left to come, because I'm at McKelvey's house. I'm on baby watch right now. McKelvey's due to have her baby any day. So before we left, I said, you know, our anniversary is coming up, and for our anniversary, I'm not going to post anything on social media, because he's like, maybe we should post something, our kids and everything, and I just said, you know what, no.
I asked her if we wanted to post anything on social media, in a little way as a test, but, you know, to protect our kids. She says no. It's the first time I've ever actually been able to go, okay, wow, she's serious about this. I think I want to keep testing it, though. You know, you never know, and she's just going to realize that the life she's looking to create somewhere else isn't
going to
be any better than what she's had or got.
I mean, wow. Talk about. Did this guy really just say this? Wow. So basically, in a nutshell, he's saying that the grass is not greener on the other side. And he wants her to recognize that before she makes the biggest mistake of her life. I mean, to be honest with you, the fact that he even talks about, oh, wow, she's actually being serious about this, that is a massive problem because it means that he has not been taking anything that she has said seriously. In fact, it shows that he hasn't taken anything that a lot of the wives have been saying. And he thinks that, listen, it's always going to be okay because, well, we're married and you're going to stick in this family no matter what because it's what we do. But in reality, I guess it's not what we do because, of course, Christina's made it abundantly clear that she's out and it's now finally hitting him. But at the same time, though, when we look at the track record of Janelle leaving and then coming back, of course, that would make him feel like, well, you're leaving. But are you really, though? Because this has been done before. And then also at the same time, Christina has, you know, pretty much alluded to it many times as well. So that also plays a factor. And then also we're looking at the whole situation with Mary as well. But again, they're all still here. So the fact that Christine's left at this moment in time, but they've always still been here regardless. And they even was happy to just get on with Robin as well, despite their differences. So is that a good enough reason to say that it's okay for him to be speaking the way he speaks? No, because the way he's speaking is very rude. Very obnoxious, very naive, very narcissistic, to be fair. And it's very inconsiderate because he doesn't consider any of the things because he expects them to stay no matter what. But now they want to leave. He wants to talk about how it's going to be the bigger mistake of their life. Oh, man. When the moment you realize that the person you're with actually has never been taking anything that you've been saying seriously, that is quite sad. But anyway, we continue.
I don't wear our wedding rings anymore most of the time. I just feel like they're a noose, to be honest with you. About 3 months ago, I asked him not to come over anymore. I went up to my room, and I took my rings off. And gosh, it felt so good just to take them off. It's over. I don't know what point it's over. Like, I don't know what the final... I'm guessing it's when I asked him to not come over anymore. That's what I'm guessing. Cody and I never had a legal marriage. Like, it was a spiritual marriage. And I don't know at what point our marriage is technically over. Because there was no real marriage contract. Cody and I were married for 26 years. This would have been our 27th wedding anniversary. It's a long time to be with somebody. We had a lot of great times. We have wonderful kids. And we both are who we are today because of the marriage and the time we had together. So it's not a failure. But I realized there's no real intimacy. I mean, sex has been something that has been missing for sure. But the intimacy of the marriage, it just wasn't there.
Intimacy needs trust. Attraction, in my world, needs trust. And I...
He can talk about trust all he wants, but the fact is, though, how can you talk about trust when efforts haven't even been made from your side? And when I say efforts, I don't mean efforts of trust haven't been made from your side. What I mean is that the general effort that you should be making in a relationship, he hasn't made that. He's expected them to always be there no matter what. And at the same time, how are they meant to gain this so-called trust if he's not allowing them to actually gain this so-called trust? It's funny, though, he says a lot of things, but he's not really saying much because everything that he says is nothing that he's looking to do himself, which is why I guess he is that narcissist. Why I guess he's always been one of the most hated TLC stars of all time until Jason came over from Unexpected. But we continue.
Thought she was being mean. I was angry. He's like, God, man, you're unwinding plural marriage from me. You're unwinding my whole life, my whole purpose. No, we're not having intimacy until you get this straight. And I wish I would have, not even been that angry, but I wish I would have actually said, well, we got to work on some things.
The future is huge and unknown. I wish so bad I could move to Utah right now. I think that's the saddest part, is that I'm not moving on as fast as I would like. Isabel and Gwendolyn still live at home, and they will live at home until they both move to go to college. I still will move, just after the girls have moved out, and just moving in September. Anyway, that was it. It's just been a weird day, I guess. But no expectations, right? There you go.
I didn't have any contact with Christine on her anniversary. It is just an affirmation that it's over. But I'm still wondering. I mean, goodness, she hasn't even told her sister wife what's going on. But I do think she's told all of her kids, I'll bet you. Those who are in the rumor mill know.
I mean, to be honest with you, why does it matter who she's told? How is that a factor? Oh yeah, it's not a factor. But anyway, we continue.
Well, it's important because two major things have changed. Schools have opened up so kids can go back into the classroom.
We're having this meeting, and it seems like she's trying to actually run our meeting. Like she's trying to take charge of it. She's getting kind of independent woman now. There's literally an attitude of I don't need you guys anymore, and I don't have to submit myself to what the group wants. Well, let's first.
I mean, that's just bull, absolute bull. But okay.
I mean, I haven't seen Christine or Janelle for a while, or even you, Mary. Janelle, how is North Carolina?
It's great. We're doing great. I had already scheduled like 2 months ago to be in North Carolina. Savannah's online school, so we just decided to take the advantage and go.
So Axel and Evie, how are they doing?
Yeah, they're doing good. They're cute. So we're enjoying the hangout for sure. So, you know, I think Cody has his opinions about my choosing to travel, but I'm sort of like, you know, I have to see my kids. You can choose and I'll choose. That's what he always says, you choose. And I'm like, okay, I'll choose.
I'm actually kind of experiencing some wish that I could go see him and be there. And, you know, I just have to do it via wishful proxy with Janelle. Christine, how's McKelty doing?
She's having real contractions now, not just Braxton Hicks. I adore McKelty. She came to live with me before I married Cody, and so we have a really close bond. McKelty has invited me to the baby's birth, and I am kind of trying to figure out if there's a way that I can go. We're still dealing with COVID crap, and so I'm trying to work it out right now. So this midwife has done, like, I don't know, 60,000 births. She's the most experienced midwife.
Maybe 5,000, maybe 1,000 births, maybe 2,000, 60,000.
Oh, it's insane. And then she's calm. She's so calm.
McKelty's, oh no, the midwife is calm. Is McKelty calm?
Calmer than Tony. Oh my gosh, he's not an at-home birth. He's not. He's only ever heard of hospital births, and his mom had hospital births, and he's never even heard of home births.
So before I met Cody's family, I didn't even know you could have a baby at home anymore. Still, that seemed like an olden days kind of pioneer thing or something, right? Really, truly, I think anybody who's had a home birth would say the recovery at home is miles beyond the recovery in a hospital.
All right, let's talk about school and COVID-19, the new school policies. What's going on? This year, the kids have been doing school online because of COVID-19, and we're in the middle of spring break. After spring break, they set it up so the kids can go back to school. I personally would prefer them to do it from home online than to go and wear a mask at school.
Savannah has decided to...
It's a shame that what you prefer nobody cares about. But anyway, we continue.
Stay home and just stay online. I think most of her friends are.
So Ariella is not in school yet, and Solomon is doing really good because he's online. So all of Robin's kids will probably just stay online.
So Isabel initially, like, they were told they could all go back to the classroom, but she's like, I told her, I know you're a senior, so you really want to go back in person. And she's like, I do. Isabel's a senior. After graduation, well, she doesn't want to stay in Flagstaff. So she always has known that, and because of it, she's got only a few more weeks with her friends. So I would like her to go in person. I don't know what that means, though. I don't know if that means that Cody can't come over anymore, so she's going to go back to school. Is that what that means? They're going to be really strict protocols, it sounds like, though, at the school.
I wonder how many, I don't know, they're strict protocols, but you're still, it's not like going in and out of a grocery store, it's like going into a building in the same room and sitting there for hours, you know, breathing the same air and all that stuff. I'm really glad that Savannah is staying home, because that makes it easier for, you know, like, I mean, we don't have to worry about anything at your house, Janelle, but if Isabel's going to go back to school, that totally changes everything at your house, Christine.
Okay, so you wouldn't be able to come over and stuff if Isabel goes back to school?
Yeah, I don't know, but I don't know, I guess that's up to you. I mean, I'm feeling really bad for Izzy having to choose between her dad and her friends. It frustrates me that Cody is making it so much like, if you go to school, I can't see you. Because I think that's ridiculous.
I mean, listen, Janelle, we know how it works. It's Cody's way, or it's no other way. You know, Cody sits there and he's surprised why he's the villain. He sits there and he's surprised why the family is, or the kids, shall I say, are so against him. Why they start to fall out, don't really want to be around him. Any parent that will put their child in the middle of a decision that is evolving, improving himself, shouldn't really be a parent. Like, end of the day, the answer should be whatever the kid believes is the best thing for them, educational wise. That's exactly what they should do. But hey, what do I know? Let's continue.
Well, she's going to be able to see her friends daily. I mean, if that's important to her, I would do it. It's just going to make it so that, here's the thing, everybody can do what they want, but I can't be exposed to people, and then I can't be going from house to house all the time.
I feel like Christine's trying to pin me down. Even Janelle's trying to pin me down on what I'm going to do, because I sometimes feel like they want to catch me in some kind of COVID protocols hypocrisy. So I'm being super careful about answering them. I want to see Isabel. I'm trying to see how accommodating Christine will be for that, because she's traveled like crazy, making it so I wasn't able to see the kids anyway.
You know what, I wonder though, Cody, when are you feeling like you could have a normal life again? I mean, at what point is the infection rate low enough? At what point, I mean, like, at what point is that point?
What's your chances, really, of getting the virus from Isabel, who goes to school and is completely no contact? I am crossing a line.
I mean, let's be real. When are you actually ever going to leave Robin's side to actually see your kids, to spend time with your kids, you know, and actually spend time with your other wives? You know what I mean? But hold on a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Let's not forget, though, when it comes to Cody, he expects everybody to stay regardless. He expects everyone to obey regardless.
But I don't know. I just can't. It just frustrates me so much that I can't keep my mouth shut.
Cody, you can still go see her and be apart from her.
It's your kid. Go see her in the backyard. Call her on the phone.
It was snowing when we started this call.
There's more for me to consider here, and there always has been, than Christine and her needs.
I wonder though, Cody, when are you feeling like you can have a normal life again?
It frustrates me that Cody is making it so much like a, if you go to school, I can't see you. I think that's ridiculous.
Well, when I feel comfortable that I couldn't get it and then spread it to somebody else, not worried about me being sick, even though I've got like health goals that I want to be able to focus on and stuff like that.
I kind of want everybody to make their choice, but I'm really feeling awkward. Because you can hear it in Janelle and Christine's voice. I hear this sort of nuance, this sarcasm of, well, are you going to keep doing what you're doing? Because it's really stupid compared to what we think. And it's this snotty little attitude about the rules and stuff like that I've had. And I'm sort of tired of the snotty attitude. So I'm just being supportive. Isabel, go do your thing. Figure it out.
In my head, Cody's relationship with his kids is more important than anything else. I understand Isabel's desire to return to school, but I'm also just, I'm really, really concerned about this. And it's something that I just find really, really stupid.
I mean, listen, first and foremost, Janelle, you know, it's nice that she says these things, but these things have to be called out more directly towards Cody. Whether or not he's going to listen or not is a different conversation, but yeah. Just saying, it's annoying when they say things that we're thinking, but we need them to say it to the person themselves in particular. Mm-hmm.
Well, when is Isabel talking about going back, Christine? What?
I didn't ask her. I would assume right away.
Is she not up there with you?
No. She stayed. She and Wendell in her home.
I was going to go over and see him, and she told me that she had gone to the school. Did she end up going and getting a test? She told me she was going to go talk to you about getting a test scheduled so she could go test.
She has the link to get herself tested.
Oh, all about her.
She's 17 years old. She can take care of scheduling her own test.
Some people just don't do that stuff.
This is what I'm talking about with Christine sort of like rejecting everything we used to do. She would normally set this up so that I could go over and see Isabel while she's gone. Like, hey, listen, why can't you? You got all her information. Why can't you book the testing? Help me out.
I'm in St. George. The girls are in Flagstaff. And I told them, you know, hopefully dad will reach out when he wants to come over so you guys can get COVID tested. But then he never said when he was going to go over so they can get COVID tested. They're not going to go get tested every single day, hoping and thinking that he's going to come over.
I was waiting to see kind of what this conversation was before I decided anything. Right now, Solomon and Brianna are still online. I just wanted to see kind of what this conversation was before anything else was decided, but it kind of sounds like...
Well, I've specifically asked that Brianna and Solomon not go back to school.
So he asks Brianna to not go back to school in person because he wants to be around her. But he says Isabel can go back. Gosh, Isabel would love a phone call from her dad saying, can you please not go back to school in person so I can come see you? Could you please go get COVID tested so I can come over and hang out with you because I really miss you? It is really hard for me that he just doesn't call Isabel and talk to her in person or even text her.
And I'll let Isabel know that she can just make the choice, I guess.
The whole COVID thing just isn't being handled correctly, shall I say. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's just going to have to know what the choice, you know, that it is choosing.
Brianna is not nearly as social as Isabel, especially during a senior year. You know, and Isabel had already expressed to me that she was interested in seeing her friends. She wanted to see her friends. She was struggling that she couldn't see her friends. So there's a difference, and the difference is where Isabel is at, what Isabel wants.
You can still go see her and be apart from her, like 6 feet apart in the backyard or something.
It's true. That hasn't worked through the winter. I've been really glad I've been able to go in the house and visit them. Well, I can do that, but that's been a real inconvenience so far. It's still not that warm. I mean, all the time. Here's the thing. We're doing that, and I'm willing to do that. It's a bit of an inconvenience, and it's like I need her to just make her own choice and then not be bitter about anybody else having to react to that choice, you know?
But now it's getting to be spring.
Maybe we can. Like, visiting outside might be the best situation then.
It was snowing when we started this call.
It's hard to not take it personally that he doesn't want to come over. So I'm like, it's your kid. The weather's getting better. It's spring. Go see her in the backyard. Call her on the phone.
I understand this is important for...
I mean, listen, that last one was pinpoint. Call her on the phone, see? You ain't gonna worry about COVID then, have you now, buddy? Mm-hmm.
Isabel, but truly, every time I go home, truly is really excited to see me. People have their, what they do to interact, they make effort or they don't. And when it comes to smaller children, I want to make an effort. There's a bitterness that I have in what I feel like is unfair to me while trying to go through this process and do the best.
I'm sorry, but are we supposed to care about what's fair to Cody? Oh dear, I didn't realize this was all about Cody. I thought this was called Sister Wives, not Cody and the Wives. Oh dear.
To make it fair for everybody else. And you know, so there's more for me to consider here, and there always has been, than Christine and her needs. Teenage kids don't need parents quite like, preteens do. And so the fact that Truly and I have these long conversations, we talk about what she's doing and stuff like that, and she's actually engaging me, that's still an important factor. It's important for Truly, it's important for me.
You know, I don't disagree with Cody that the younger kids need him. Absolutely, that's very important. I also believe very strongly that all of his children need him. And I...
That's not even something that you have to strongly believe. That is something that is just fact. He's supposed to care about every single one of them. It's more annoying when it feels like he's spending more time with his adopted kids rather than his biological kids. The fact that we're sitting here listening to conversations about children and how it should be done, it's just poor, man. Like, do better. Do better.
I wonder if he realizes that. I don't want to criticize Cody, but I disagree. I think that kids need their parents for the rest of their lives. And I know for a fact that some of our older kids, they need their dad.
Right, I'm sorry, guys, talking about the time zone, and I can hear the babies and everything, so I need to get going. But
I've pretty much, like, I've mentally washed my hands of this conversation. Like, everybody's just going to do what they're going to do. So I'm going to do what I'm going to do.
All right, let's wrap this up. It's good seeing everybody. Safe travels, ladies.
All right, see ya. Bye. I have more unanswered questions at the end of this conversation than I did at the beginning of the conversation. And really, is this all going to be Isabel's decision, whether she sees her dad or her friends? This seems like a very hard decision for a 17-year-old kid. My mom has been in the hospital for 2 days. I found out that she had been having a heart attack for a few days. She's coding, and they're working on her, and I have 5 hours to get there. Yeah, now it's not looking good, so I've got to run up there.
Sweet, okay, we love you.
Love you too. I mean, I assume Robin knows that Mine and Cody's relationship is over just because Cody's moved all of his stuff. You know, it wasn't the garage, but it's not there anymore. I don't know how much he knows, though. We haven't talked with all of the adults about everything yet. So I don't know what Robin knows. I have no idea, but it doesn't even matter. We're here for McKelty right now. And that's what we're going to focus on. It's just about McKelty Day.
Is my
fish
done?
Yes.
You're nervous.
Yeah, it's hard.
I mean, listen, if Cody knows, Robin knows. Robin will probably know. Robin probably knew before Christine even knew about her own choice. Okay, whatever. Nonetheless, though, there isn't really much else that happens in this episode. It's pretty much obviously about the childbirth, pretty much. So we'll leave it there, ladies and gentlemen. But hey, you guys let me know what you're thinking down below. But as far as I'm concerned, at the end of the day, nothing's new, nothing's changed. Cody's still the same with Cody, you know. And it's more annoying that it's only one wife walking away. And it's going to be even more annoying if Christine does eventually potentially decide to come back as well, because that would just feed his ego even more. Which is something that we don't want the slightest, if you dig what I'm saying. So we just got to see what happens throughout the season. I mean, obviously, right now we know that obviously they're not together, you know, but you never know, because sometimes it's always a hit or miss with the Browns in general. But I really hope that one day is in wishful thinking, Cody decides to pull his head out of his own ass and realize that his actions do affect other people, and not in the way that he thinks it does, but in the way that we all see it, and those are the negative ways. But hey, you guys let me know what you're thinking down below in the comment section. We'll talk about it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and peace.